Hey everybody, this is Ori from AsterWeb, and I'm going to showcase to you the Shopify Product Reviews app. Okay, so by default, Shopify, the functionality, the system does not allow you to showcase product reviews, to collect product reviews, and to have customers actually view them. So what you have to do is you have to find an app. And there's many apps out there, but the one I'm going to cover today in the video is the free one that's actually built by Shopify, not by a third party, built by them. It's free, it's pretty good functionality, but on the other side, on the downside, there's not that much customization you can do. So different projects, different shops may need different requirements. I'm going to show you the most basic and the free option. Okay, great. So this is what a product page would look like, for example, and then here's a widget, right? So we're going to actually do this kind of thing. Okay, so what are we going to do? Let's go ahead and install it. I've installed it before, and actually I'm going to go ahead and actually I've uninstalled it right now for the video, and I'm going to reinstall it. Okay, so I'm going to go here to the App Store, and I'm going to type in product reviews. Product reviews. I'm going to go here, find the product reviews. There's 1,200 reviews. It's really good. I use it for multiple of our projects. I'm going to click on Add App. Okay, it's made by Shopify, as you can see here. Okay, so once you do that, you're going to actually have to install it, allow it to have its permissions. If it's okay with you, you click on install. Okay, and once you do that, you're going to have to do one step to actually install it on your theme, on your front end. But because I've already installed it before, I'm going to half skip this page. You're not going to see this if you have a new installation. So I'm going to get back to it in a second. But what you are going to see is you're going to go to this installation instructions page. And so it's going to tell you how you actually have to put certain code on your product pages template and also on your collections template. Okay, so I've already done this, but the simple rule of thumb is if you're not a developer, don't do this. Just hire a developer. You can hire us to do it. You can have your own developer. Just find someone that knows code, because if you try to do this and you have a theme that doesn't exactly fit this and you don't know what you're doing, you could break your whole site. And obviously, developers have a better workflow. They set up a test site, a complete different theme. They test on it. They preview. If everything's okay, then they switch over, right? So what are you going to do? You're going to click here and actually go ahead and copy this line of code. You're going to add it here below the product description, okay? So if I go here, obviously, I've added it already. But if you see here, here's my product description, and I just add it right below. The second thing you want to do is for collections, you're going to click here and you're going to copy this code and you're going to go to your product grid item code. Okay, so I'm going to go here. Obviously, in this case, I've already implemented it. It's kind of at the bottom, right below everything. But again, if you're not sure, hire someone professional to do that. Okay, so once I do that, I can go and verify that everything's working. If it's okay, it'll say, hey, congratulations. And then if I click here, it'll take me to a product page and I can see an example. So now we've added this widget, this kind of box right below all of our buy now and add to cart buttons. Okay, so let's look at a few things. Let's set it up first before we actually look at how you actually manage these things. So first of all, I'm going to go to settings and I'm going to look at a few things. Okay, first one. For spam purposes, when a customer actually writes a review, so for example, I click here, I'm a customer, okay, I click on write a review, let me actually refresh the page, okay, I click on write a review. If I actually submit a review as a customer, then will the actual review appear on the page immediately, or does it have to go through a review, a manual process of the business to accept it? Because there's a lot of spam and things that you don't want, maybe content that you don't want people to do. So what I recommend, especially for a new business, is have this disabled. So basically every single review that's actually written, you actually go and manually do a review it and then publish it or delete it. And I'll show you a little bit later how we actually do that. Other than that, you have email settings. Here's, you check boxes if you want to get an email every time a review is submitted, so you can go and manually publish it. You can change the actual style, either inherit the theme colors, which I prefer, or you can change some of the colors right here and change the color. Also, this is a setting. So when you go to the product page, you can decide if the reviews are shown by default or the customer has to click on this to show the reviews. So it depends on your style, how you want to implement it. but different businesses have different ones, okay? So here I can say, hey, show reviews, and I want to show up to two on a page. And if there's more than two, for example, you can change colors, by the way. So let's go crazy on the colors. Let's change that. So if I go here and I save it, you'll be able to see that colors change. Okay, and also I'm showing one review right here, right? So I basically said show up to two reviews at a time. If there's more than two reviews, for example, I'll show you an example here. Here there's four reviews. Then you'll be able to see that there's a pagination, right? So there's two per page. Okay, next one. So here you can change some padding, this kind of the spacing, and then you can also change a lot of the words here. So if you look at the widgets, you can change this, you can change this, you can change that. Every single word or most of the words you have, you can actually change them. So I'm going to skip this, but it's pretty, pretty straightforward. Okay. There's no reviews, you know, what text would it say? It's just very intuitive. So I'm going to kind of skip this. Okay. Other than that, you can actually here show the review form on load. So what that means, if someone actually clicks on write a review, do I want to have them click and then open, or do I want it to actually be visible, right? Immediately the form. So this is what we call the form. This part is the form. Okay. Do I want to show it? Yes or no. Okay. And these are just the words that, you know, email, name, etc. Very, very simple. Okay. Other than that, you know, this is just content itself. Okay. Other than that, that's basically the settings themselves. So let's go back here. So now that if we go back to the app and just click app and product reviews, that's the page I was a second ago. Here I'll be able to, of course, sort, you know, filter, but also I'll see every single review I have here. And the reviews are very simple. You can do two things. Number one, you can actually go and click on it and you can reply to a review. For example, you know, appreciate the kind words, right? So it's really good to respond to your customers, okay? The other thing you can do is unpublish or publish, and you can also delete, right? So this is really simple. So let's go here to my product. Okay, and you'll be able to see this is the I love it comment. Okay, so I love it. And I'm going to go here to view in your store. I love it. And here's the actual business response, right? So it's really good to do that. Okay, so let's go back here to product reviews. And what you can do, you can also unpublish it. So if I unpublish it right here, then it won't be visible here. There's no what, right? There's no I love it and what, okay? And these are just examples, okay? So that's really simple. I think you understand that, okay? Other than that, what you can do, you can also, you know, checkbox, do things from here, bulk action. You can, you know, delete or publish or unpublish, right? And that's pretty much it. This is really simple. You can use a search field, or you can use these ready searches, you know, to kind of filter. And the last two things are you can do on this app, import and export. So let's say you want to export all your reviews. You click on it and you actually go and view it. That's it. So let's click on it. You can see all of it. If you want to use it for other marketing purposes or just have a list, you have everything here. This is the product handle, basically the URL and the unique identifier of the product. Is it published, unpublished? What's the star rating? What's the title? Who is it by? What's their email, the customer email? Location we don't use in this case. The actual text, the body, did the business reply? And then when was it created? And when was it replied to, if at all? Okay. So other than that, I'm going to show you the last thing, which is the import. So let's say you want to actually import. Maybe you have customer reviews from other places. Okay. So what do you do? What you're going to do is you're going to click here on import. And you're going to download the CSV. You're going to download a template that you can follow that you can easily do. So if I click on it, I do this. Now, I've already prepared for this video, so the thing that I clicked on is exactly right here. So everything that you've seen here, the product handle, the state, etc. So what you're going to do is just copy this, and you're going to make your own, right? So you're just going to import everything and follow this. So let's add one just to show you what's going on. So how do I figure out what the product handle is, first of all? So I can go here, I can go to my backend right here, I can click on products, I can find the product that I have a review of, let's say it's this one, for example, and I go here to the SEO features, and I can find the handle right here. This is my handle. So I would actually put it right here. Okay. And then is it published or unpublished? I'm going to publish it. Let's say it's a 5-star. Their review was they love it. You know, the author was, you know, James Jones. Okay. And then their email, James. Okay. Okay. We don't need the locations not used in this theme. And then the review was whatever it is. You know, this is a test review. Okay. Did the business reply? Let's say no. Was it, when was it created? You can just copy the example and keep the same exact formatting: year, month, day, you know, hour, minute, etc., second, and time zone, right? So you can keep that, just change it. For example, it's already 2020. Okay, now that I finished it, I have to go file, download as CSV, okay, comma separated values. And then I go back here, and I click on import, and I select the file, okay, downloads, I believe it's this one, and I click on import, and it failed. So let's see what happened. Why did it fail? Go here. Okay, so I figured out what's going on. So the file that we saved as a CSV was actually using special characters in the name itself. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to try one more time, and I'll show you what's going on. So I click on download as CSV, and I go to the file name right here, and I look at it, and you see there's these round brackets and spaces, etc. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to rename it, make it a shorter one with no spaces, no round brackets, just letters, numbers, and underscores. That's it. Okay. Actually, I'll just do without that. So I'm just going to call it import one. Okay. .csv. Okay. Very simple. I have it, and I'm going to go back here, file, import, select, and I selected import one. Okay. After I selected that, I click on import and should run in process. Okay. So you see here, this is my actual review right here. Love it from James Jones, etc. Love it. Okay. From James Jones. Okay. And it shows the product that it's associated with. Hope this makes sense to you. That's basically it. If you have any questions, you're not sure how to use it, happy to answer. Hope you enjoyed this video. Again, thank you for watching our videos.